Hello, and welcome to another tutorial from Typhoon HIL. In this tutorial, we will cover test automation and in-house pre-certification for PV, battery storage, and wind converter controllers using controller hardware-in-the-loop simulation techniques. In this example, we will test a PV inverter controller against the BDEW TR3 standard using the AIT certified test suite toolbox from Typhoon HIL. For the purpose of this tutorial, we will show you only one of the tests covered by BDEW, which is LVRT, low voltage ride through. We will start by creating a project and test suite. Let's name it PV controller, add a description, and save. Notice that the project file will store all the settings for your test, so that you can simply reuse the test scenarios. On the left side of test suite, you can see a library of the available tests. Let's choose the BDEW low voltage ride through test, which is designed to assess the performance of the controller in case of voltage dips. The test configuration wizard guides you through all relevant test parameters. We can define the depth of our test in a few simple steps. First, we open the model we created in Schematic Editor library and the initial settings file. This is the model of the power stage we will use in this tutorial. The rated power of the converter is 34.5 kilowatts, and the grid voltage is 400 volts. You can select the desired test parameters of your controller in order to save time before you start the complete certification process. To illustrate this, we'll choose just a subset of the possible fault parameters. 3-phase faults, 0.7 to 0.8 ratio of fault voltage to initial voltage, and 100% active power reference. The grid simulator and DC meter elements are included in our power stage model and will be simulated on the hill with a 1 microsecond update rate. Let's set the delay between dips. Choose the deadband according to TC2007 because we are testing a PV controller, type of reference point signal, and stiff grid characterization. In this step, the wizard allows you to map the control feedback through the analog output. Finally, you can set user actions at particular testing points by using the options from the drop-down menu. In this case, after starting simulation and before stopping it, we'll leave nothing for both actions. One last click on the next button and setting the test parameters is finished. Now you can add other tests in the queue the same way. In the end, you can select the tests you want to run or a complete list of tests and leave the test suite to do all the work for you. Once the tests are done, the tool will generate a detailed test report you can use to check the results. The report files contain detailed explanations, tables, and charts of your test results. In conclusion, we've shown you the potential of using test suite toolboxes to automate your testing processes. For a detailed explanation and more information about particular standards and grid codes, feel free to contact us directly. Thank you for watching and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more tutorials.